Sitting at the hotel, Ostello Bello Hotel, in the middle of Milan, and we have in the last day, four days, we've been through line check. And among the bands which is coming here from Denmark, we have Elba, the band Elba. And in front of us we have Ellen. Ellen, will you please introduce you and your band?
Of course. My name is Ellen, and I'm the artist of Elba, and Elba is my solo project. It's very synth popish and very good vibes on the dance floor. So yeah, and we're actually having a single released, our first single release on Friday. So you should stay tuned, definitely.
Yes. And you have been on stage Saturday at 9 o'clock p.m. In front of an audience, in front of perhaps managers, producers, who knows, who was coming to see you and to join you, perhaps, and to recognize everything is possible down here. Perhaps you'll be contacted, perhaps not. It's very exciting. Have you something highlights from the line check you want to talk about?
It was a very great experience just to be at the line check festival, because we were being met by so many great people, first for all, and it was very professional, the whole vibe, and just the vibe was very nice. And we also saw some very great acts, both from Denmark but also from the other countries. So that was a very great experience.
Yes, and here on the hotel, the Ostello, you have been together with all the other bands from Slovenia, Italian, France, England, Greece. You have spoken to them, or have you make some jam session or something?
We have definitely spoken together, and we actually shared a room with a Danish band called Elatif. They're based in Berlin right now, but yeah, we have talked a lot on Schwarze Vision, also from Denmark,
So you have made some contacts, some opportunities for the future work, perhaps?
Perhaps.
Yes.
We don't know, but we have talked to a lot of great, amazing people. Basically.
Yes, yes. Would you come here again, if you have the opportunity?
I think Milan is a very great city, so I'll definitely consider being back in Milan again.
That's good. And you have 3 more members of your band, Elba.
No, it's actually my solo project.
Yes, so you and you have three more musicians.
Yeah, musicians, but they're only a part of the live setup. They're not a part of my solo project.
Okay.
Yeah, so it's in my own name, the whole thing is being released and stuff. But yeah, they're 3 amazing people.
Yes, they are, and you're good together. I saw you yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
So
thank you.
Yeah. Thank you, Ellen, and have a nice future.
Bye bye.
So, now we are sitting here, guys, on the 4th day of the Line Check Festival in Milan. How are you?
Fine.
You're fine. Yeah. You look glad.
A bit tired.
It's your work to make some music.
Yeah.
But it's hard work.
Yeah, it's hard work, but it's been so great. People here has been fantastic, and the place we at the Ostello Bello has been so wonderful to stay here. And the concert at the Basse was perfect.
Yes.
Lots of people there and a great response afterwards. So yeah.
So the Basse is the place you are playing the Line Check Festival.
Yeah,
that's the base. Yes.
Yeah, we played Friday night.
Yes, we played Friday night.
Yeah, at 11 p.m. and it was perfect.
Yeah.
Yes, and how about the audience?
Amazing.
Yeah.
Okay.
There were a lot of people and the response was amazing.
Okay.
A lot of people came to us and say, "Well, thank you for the show." And so we really, really, really have it.
So you have got some contacts.
Yeah,
with other musicians or
some people from the business too.
Okay.
So when we arrive in Denmark later this evening, we're looking forward to get up tomorrow and contact those people.
Okay.
Yeah, to pick it up.
Yeah, and talk to other musicians about continuing networking and playing their country, and then they come to our country and in double concerts with them, so yeah.
So it has not only been the music.
No. This thing is concert, a showcase, but it's mostly connecting with people from all over the world.
Yes, yes. And you have met all the other bands here in Ostello.
Yeah, a lot of them.
Yeah.
Some bands have been playing one day and then we met them the day after, because then they were off and they did their show and they were a bit more relaxed, so they could chill out in the lounge, and then we met them and talked, and everybody's been so great.
Yes.
Yeah.
And now you are talking with you two, but who are you? Your name is?
My name is...
Your group name is Schwarze Fiktion?
Yeah.
Yeah?
And I'm Bo, and I'm the lead singer in the band, and I also play guitar and synth.
Yeah, and I'm Sean, and I play guitar, also synth, and kind of controlling the laptop.
We have some backtracks when we play. Sometimes we have a drummer with us, but the act is as strong without a drummer, so it's
okay.
Mostly Søren and me, and our sound engineer, who is a big part of the act, actually. Yeah.
What was the highlights? Have you a single highlight from the Line Check?
Yeah, our concert. It was so amazing. The crew around the stage was so nice. The sound engineers and playing there, and the way the stages were built, the A stage, when a band was playing, another band prepared and had a sound check on the B stage and vice versa. So it took 2 minutes from a concert ending for people to move to the other stage. But when we played, it took about a minute, I think, in the first song, and then the concert room was half full, and then people came longer.
And then also the day after, we played a little acoustic concert here at Ostello.
Actually, on this stage where we're speaking now.
And that was really cool, where we kind of cut off all the backtracks and just played guitars
and sang.
Yeah. That was really nice. And again, the audience was amazing.
Yeah. And that concert got filmed, and I think it will be available on the Nimbus homepage later. And actually, the people who came supported it and were so nice and came up afterwards and thanked us for the music. We were thanking them for being there. So,
Okay. And you are Bo and Søren and Schwarze Fiktion.
Yeah.
You become rather famous in Denmark. the last few months. Tell me about it.
It's been busy, actually.
You've been busy, yes?
Yeah, we played this Bronze Festival spot. In May.
And Spot Festival in Denmark.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
And it's a festival for the business. A lot of people from all over the world, managers, labels, and so on, come to see upcoming acts. Spot if they can see anything potential in this. And afterwards, we actually been so busy. This is actually a tour because the day before we came to Milano, we played in Denmark as a support for a Danish band called The Minds of 99, who's smashing at the moment. They are totally great. And a sold out venue called Posten in Odense. It was amazing. 800 people, and the energy was so cool. So, yeah.
And that was filmed by the whole concert.
Yeah.
It was filmed and it would be released tomorrow, I think.
Yeah.
And another thing tomorrow is that the National Danish Radio has picked one of our tunes to be the week's canon, in week 48. So that is also
launched
tomorrow. So.
And I'll say from here, tomorrow it's the past when they are looking at the movie here.
Yeah.
So today is a secret, tomorrow is not a secret.
No.
Okay. Okay.
But the thing is that it's national radio that plays it, and that means a lot when you're an upcoming band.
Yeah.
Because then people who's following Zwarte Fiction really can hear, okay, something is happening, but also a lot of people that don't know Zwarte Fiction will be able to hear it. And it's going to be played on something called Itai, which is the broadest listener stage or channel. And then on something called P6 Beat, and that is cool because it's more niche. So, yeah, and then we have some concerts when we, I think in a week or so, we're gonna play again, so it's pretty...
So you're glad?
Yeah,
all over, yes. Thank you so much, Bo and Søren from Zwarte Fiction.
Yeah.
Good luck with the future.
Yeah, thank you.
We are now sitting here, the fourth day of the Line Check Festival. It's the last day before we went back to our countries. And here from Denmark, we have two Germans, and one from Germany and one from Spain. And the two guys here is relative. Relative is Laura and Markus. Please tell me about relative.
Okay, so we have the shot. Hi, we are a band and we do music together, which is electronic music influenced by hip-hop and soul. And I think, yeah. Do you want to tell like what the
story is? Yeah. It's two of us here now, but our band is comprised of four members. Two of them couldn't be here, so that's why it's only Markus and I. But yeah, we play electronic music, hip hop musical influence. We like jazz a lot. We like sampling. We like hats. We like, yeah, that's what we do.
And you did your music work at the base.
Uh-huh.
At Friday night.
Friday night.
Am I right? Yes.
9 p.m. on.
Yes. How was it?
We had a lot of fun. It was a bit difficult because the doors had just opened, and of course it wasn't super packed. But it started filling up after some time, and the audience was great. I had a lot of fun personally. There's always things to improve, and there's always things you wish would have been different. But overall, we walk out with a good impression.
Okay, and now you're staying at the hotel.
Yeah.
For all the bands.
Yes.
Yes.
That was nice. That was.
Have you made any jam session or have you spoken to them?
We have talked a lot. We have had late night conversations. and cigarettes. But yeah, it's been a great stay here, especially the staff has been amazing. Really, so warm and so
very friendly.
Very friendly.
And yeah, open. Also, like the other bands that we met, we got along great with everybody, and yeah.
It was good to share this with so many other bands in the same, living the same experience as we were living.
Yeah.
So that's a part of it.
Yeah, for sure. For sure. It was, for me, it was the highlight, like meeting the other bands and learning about their projects and their backgrounds, and also meeting the staff. The staff here at the hostel was great.
Yes.
The most human part was the greatest.
Yeah. Have you made any contacts with, for example, opportunities for the future? Have you made some contacts with music producers or management or?
So I met myself.
You met yourself as a producer?
On a different way.
Yeah. Producers or managers from other countries, perhaps.
Yeah, I mean, we've stayed with other musicians here, and we plan to do some exchange of ideas and collaborations in the future, maybe. And also we met other nice people, like by chance, at the events, and spoke with them. And
some speakers and people from the industry that we have plans already to talk to in the future. So that was very unexpected, but very cool.
Yeah. What was the highlight?
The highlight of what?
Of the weekend.
Sorry.
I think for me, as we said, it was like meeting everybody, meeting all the bands, meeting all the artists. The people working at the festival also were super nice. Like we felt very welcome and very taken care of. All the girls working at the staff there was amazing. That was for me the highlight, I think. Of course, being able to play our music here was also really cool. But I think what I personally liked the most was the more human side of everything, connecting with people.
Yes. Would you like to come and again to the Linetech Festival?
I want to come to the Milan Music Week and check out everything that's happening also, because we heard that there's a lot of things happening. I would like to come back for the Music Week and see what there is.
So I think that's from now. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.